हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर डिस्कसिंग फर्स्ट एक्सरसाइज ऑफ चैप्टर लाइंस एंड एंगल। सो क्वेश्चन नंबर वन इज कैन टू राइट एंगल्स बी कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री। सो वी हैव टेकन हियर टू राइट एंगल्स 90 एंड 90। राइट एंगल मीन्स 90 डिग्री। इफ वी एड दीज टू राइट एंगल्स 90 एंड 90 वी आर गेटिंग 180। बट द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री एंगल्स इज द सम ऑफ टू एंगल शुड बी 90 डिग्री। बट हियर सम इज कमिंग 180 डिग्री। इट मीन्स नो, टू राइट एंगल्स कांट बी कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री एंगल्स। सेकेंड पार्ट, कैन टू राइट एंगल्स बी सप्लीमेंट्री। सो हियर अगेन टू राइट एंगल्स वी हैव टेकन एंड आफ्टर एडिशन वी आर गेटिंग 180 डिग्री। एंड द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ सप्लीमेंट्री एंगल्स इज दैट ओनली द सम ऑफ टू एंगल शुड बी 180 डिग्री। सो हियर वी आर गेटिंग 180 डिग्री। It means yes, two right angles are supplementary. Third part, can two adjacent angles be complementary? So for this, I have taken here one example. These two angle AOB and angle BOC are adjacent angles because one vertex is common and one ray is common in these two angles. One angle is 30 degree and another angle is 60 degree. So if we add 60 and 30, answer is coming 90 degree. And this is the property for complementary angle. It means yes, two adjacent angles can be complementary. Fourth part, can two adjacent angles be supplementary? So I have taken one example here. Two adjacent angles I have taken AOB and angle BOC. Angle A is 110 and angle AOB is 110 and angle BOC is 70 degree. If I add these two angle 110 plus 70, it is coming equal to 180 degree. So yes, two adjacent angles can be supplementary. Can two obtuse angle be adjacent? Yes, we can take two adjacent angle which are obtuse. You can see here 95 degree and again after 95 degree one more angle I have taken here 100 degree. Both the angles are obtuse angle and both are adjacent angle also. Sixth part, can an acute angle be adjacent to an obtuse angle? Yes, this one also. Here I have taken example angle AOB 110 which is obtuse angle, angle BOC 40 degree which is an acute angle, and both the angles are adjacent angle to each other. Seventh part, can two right angles form a linear pair? You can see two right angles, right angle means 90 degree, two right angles are there. If we add these two right angle, answer is coming 180 degree. So it means yes, two right angles form a linear pair angle. The sum of two angles should be 180 degree for linear pair angle. Question number 2, find the complement of each of the following angle. First angle is given 25 degree. So complement angle of 25 will be 90 minus 25. 90 minus 25 is equal to 65 degree. Second angle is given 63. So complement of 63 will be 90 minus 63. Is equal to 27 degree. Third angle 57 degree. So complement of 57 will be 90 minus 57 degree. It will be 33 degree. Next question number 3, find the supplement of each of the following angle. So to find the supplement, we have to subtract from 180 degree, for complement from 90 degree. So first angle is given 105. So supplement of 105 will be 180 minus 105 is equal to 75 degree. Second part, 87 degree. So supplement of 87 will be 180 minus 87 is equal to 93 degree. third part 142 degrees. So supplement of 142 will be 180 minus 142 is equal to 38 degree. Question number 4. Identify which of the following pairs of angle are complementary and which are supplementary. So for this question we have to add these two angles. If answer is coming equal to 180 degree, it means given angles are supplementary. If answer is coming equal to 90 degree, then angles are complementary angle. So first 55 degree and 125 degree. Sum of angles will be 55 plus 125, 180 degree. It means given angles are supplementary angles. Second part 34 degree and 56 degree. After adding 34 and 56, we are getting 90 degree. It means given angles are complementary angles. Third part 137 and 43 degree. 137 plus 43, we are getting 180 degree. So given angles are supplementary angles. Fourth part 112 degree and 68 degree. 112 plus 68, answer is coming 180 degree. So given angles are supplementary angles. Fifth part 45 degree and 45 degree. So after adding 45 and 45, we are getting 90 degree. It means these two angles are complementary angles. Sixth part 72 degree and 18 degree. After adding 72 degree and 18 degree, we are getting 90 degree. So these two angles are complementary angles. Next question number 5, first part. Find the angle which is equal to its complementary. So let first angle is x degree and its complementary also x degree, because both the angles are equal. Now we will use the property of complementary angles. The sum of two complementary angle will be 90 degree. So x plus x is equal to 90 degree. You have to mention reason compulsory in bracket. X plus x will become 2x equal to 90 degree. Now this 2 shift another side, it will go for division. So x value will be 45 degree. So each angle is 45 degree and 45 degree. Fifth second part, find the angle which is equal to its supplementary. So let the angle is x and its supplementary angle also is x, because both angles are equal. Next x plus x will be 180 degree, because these two angles are supplementary angles. It is mentioned in question. X plus x will become 2x equal to 180 degree. Again this 2 we will shift another side, it will go for division. 180 divided by 2 is 90 degree. So x value is here 90 degree. Both the angles are 90 degree. Next question number 6. Two complementary angles are x plus 4 and 2x minus 7. Find the value of x. Because these two given angles are complementary, it means the sum of these two angles will be 90 degree. So x plus 4 plus 2x minus 7 is equal to 90 degree. Now x to x, like terms we will add. X plus 2x will become 3x, 4 minus 7 will become minus 3. Next step, this minus 3 shift another side, it will become plus 3. 90 plus 3 will become 93. Again this 3 shift another side, here it is in multiplication. When you will shift another side, it will go for division. So 93 divided by 3 equal to 31 degree. So x value is here 31 degree. Question number 7. Two supplementary angles are in the ratio of 2 is to 7. Find the angle. Here ratio of two angles are given. So let angles are 2x and 7x. Because these two angles are supplementary, it means their sum will come 180 degree. So 2x plus 7x equal to 180 degree. 2x plus 7x is 9x is equal to 180 degree. This 9 shift another side, it will go for division. So x value will be 20 degree. And we have to find out both the angles also. So substitute x value in angle. First angle is 2x, 2 into 20, 40 degree. Second angle is 7x, 7 into 20, 140 degree. Next question number 8. Among two supplementary angles, the measure of the longer angle is 44 degree more than the measure of the smaller angle. Find the angles. Here two angles are given. One is small, one is bigger. They have given bigger angle is 44 degree more than the smaller angle. So let us smaller angle is x, so longer angle will be x plus 44 because it is more. More means we have to add. So both the angles are supplementary. Supplementary means their sum should come 180 degree. So if both the angle x plus 44, it will come equal to 180 degree. X plus x will become 2x. 44, you can shift another side, it will become minus 44. 180 minus 44 is equal to 136. Next step, this 2 is here in multiplication. Shift another side, it will go for division. Then x value will be 68 degree. You have to find both the angles also. So x value substitute in here. So smaller angle is x, smaller angle is 68 degree, longer angle is x plus 44. 68 plus 44, 112 degree. Question number 9. If an angle is half of its complement, find the measure of the angle. So let angle is x, then its complementary angle will be 2x. Because this angle is half of this, so this angle I have taken x, it will be double of this. Half of this 2x will be x. And because these two angles are complementary, so their sum will come 90 degree. So x plus 2x is equal to 90 degree. X plus 2x is equal to 3x. 3x is equal to 90 degree. So x will be 90 by 3. 3 shift another side equal to 30 degree. So angles will be, first angle is x, 30 degree. Second angle is 2x. 2 into 30, 60 degree. Question number 10. Two adjacent angles are in the ratio of 5 is to 3 and they together form an angle of 120 degree. So here ratio of two angles are given and together they form 120 degree. It means their sum is 120 degree. So let angles are 5x and 3x. Then according to the question, if we add these two angles, answer should come 120 degree. So 5x plus 3x, 8x is equal to 120 degree. 8, you can shift another side, it will go for division. So x value is 15 degree. Now this x value substitute for these angle. First angle is 5x, 5 into 15, 75 degree. 3x, 3 into 15, 45 degree. Question number 11, first part. Find the value of x in each of the following figure. So first figure is given here. One point and on that point four angles are there. 1, 2, 3, 4. So the sum of all these four angles should be 360 degree because these are the angles at a point. All the four angles are making a complete round. So if we add these four angles, answer should come 360 degree. So x plus 41 plus 105 plus 130 is equal to 360 degree. These numbers we can add. X will be as it is. After adding, we are getting 276 degree. X plus 276 is equal to 360. This 276 is here in addition. Shift another side, it will go for subtraction. So 360 minus 270 degree is equal to 84 degree. So x value is here 84 degree. Second part, figure is given here. First angle is 3x, second angle is x, and third angle is 40 degree. And you can see all these three angles are on a straight line. It means these are straight line angle and the sum of straight line angles is 180 degree. So if we add 3x plus x plus 40, it will be equal to 180 degree. Mention the reason in bracket because it is a straight line angles. So 3x plus x will become 4x. This 40 we can shift another side, it will go for subtraction. 180 minus 40, 140 degree. Next step, 4 also we can shift another side, it will go for division. So x value is 35 degree. Next to third part, in this also 3 angles are given and all the 3 angles are on a straight line. So again same property, angles, straight line angles we are using here. The sum of these 3 angles, this angle and this angle will be 180 degree. So 2x plus 10 plus 3x minus 10 plus 40 degree is equal to 180 degree. Now like terms we will simplify. 2x plus 3x will become 5x plus 10 minus 10 0 plus 40, 40 degree. Then this 40 degree shift another side, it will go for subtraction. So 5x is equal to 140 degree. X will be 140 divided by 5 equal to 28 degree. Question number 12. Find the value of x, y and z. First part is given here. Two lines are intersecting each other. This angle is given 135 degree. This is x, y and z. We have to find out other remaining three angles here. So you can see here when two lines will intersect each other, then we have to use vertically opposite angle. So first I am using here linear pair angle. This is a straight line. On this straight line, the sum of this and this angle, x plus 35, will be 180 degree. Reason, linear pair angle, because two angles are there, so we will mention linear pair. If three angle or four angle, then straight line angle. So this 35, we can shift another side. So x value will be 45 degree. Now next, y will be equal to 135. Reason is here vertically opposite angle. These two angles are opposite to each other. And z will be equal to x. Again the same reason, vertically opposite angle. So y value will be 135 degree. Z value will be 45 degree. And reason you have to mention within bracket. Second part, figure is given here. Three lines are intersecting each other. So L, M and N. This angle is given y, this is given 31 degree, it is given z, x, and here rectangular mark is there. It means this angle is equal to 90 degree. So first, this 31 degree and this x are vertically opposite angle. So we can write x value is equal to 31 degree. Reason, vertically opposite angle. Next, we will use the property of linear pair, straight line angle. So this z, x plus 90 plus y is equal to 180 degree because this is a straight line. So x value is 31 plus 90 plus y equal to 180 degree. 31 plus 90, 121. Shift this 121 another side, it will go for subtraction. So y value is 59 degree. Now y and z both are vertically opposite, so z value also will be 59 degree. Reason is same, vertically opposite angles. Third part, figure is given here. Three lines are cutting each other. This angle is given 51 degree, this is given 44 degree, and here it is x, y, z. First of all, we can see x and 44, both are vertically opposite angle. These two lines are intersecting each other, so this and this angle is vertically opposite angle. So we can write x is equal to 44 degree. Reason is vertically opposite angle. Similarly, this z and 51 also are opposite to each other. So we can write z equal to 51 degree. Again, same reason, vertically opposite angle. Now, this z is 51 degree. X is 44 degree. Then we can use here straight line property. This is a straight line and the sum of all the angles above straight line is equal to 180 degree. So x plus y plus z is equal to 180 degree. Substitute the x and z value. 44 plus 51, 95. Shift this 95 another side. Then y value will be 85 degree. Question number 13. In the adjoining figure, line AB and CD intersect at F. If angle EFA is equal to angle AFD and angle CFV is equal to 50 degree, find the angle EFC. We have to find out this angle. And they have given this angle is equal to this angle. These two angles are equal. So first of all, this angle AFD will be equal to 50 degree because this and this angle are vertically opposite angle. So angle AFD is equal to 50 degree, vertically opposite angle. Second thing, they have given this angle and this angle also equal to each other. So if it is 50 degree, it means this angle also will be 50 degree. This is 50 degree, vertically opposite. These two are equal, it is given in question. Next, now we can use here straight line property. AB is a straight line. Above this straight line, three angles are there. 50 and this angle and this angle. If we add these three angles, sum should come 180 degree. So after adding these three angles, answer should be 180 degree. Substitute the values 50 degree plus angle EFC plus 50 degree is equal to 180 degree. So angle EFC plus 100 equal to 180 degree. Angle EFC will be 80 degree. Thank you for watching this video.